What's up everyone? Tom here, and today I wanted to share with you a really cool mod that I recently put into my 2019 Crosstrek. For a long time I've wanted some 12 volt power in the back of the vehicle, and with this 12 volt panel that you can turn off or on, you get 12 volt cigarette lighter style power, as well as a couple of 5 volt 1.2 amp USB powers. So stick around, I'll walk you through the setup and how we got this thing installed. And hopefully it gives you some ideas and provides some help. Okay, so first thing we need to do is access the fuse panel. Right next to the steering wheel, you can just go ahead and pull this off here. And to make my life a little easier, I like to pull off this panel here. You can either pry it off. I like to give it a little bit of a push from the inside first. Not always easy. I'm always paranoid about breaking these clips. If you get it pushed out a little bit, you can use a body tool. There we go. And just pop it out. And once you're popped out, you can set that aside. In order to remove the little sill that goes along the driver's side door, you're going to want to go ahead and get this little tab out right there. And then this piece should pop out. And then from there, the rest of the door plate should also just pop right out. And there you have it. So in case you did like I just did and left the pin in the hole, these things can be a bit of a pain to get out. But you definitely want to reach behind them if you can, or so I'm told. Let's see if I can get this guy out. There we go. All right. And then you can go ahead and put this back in here for later use. Okay, I believe this back piece should come off the same way. Just grab an edge and start to peel it up. You should break the clips. Just feel for where those clips are. Bust them loose as you go. All right. This feels like there's one other thing caught in the back here, behind the seat. Yeah, I'll let that sit for now. Well, you also got to get this pillar on the side, unless you really feel like trying to route wires through there. I'm going to try to take it off just to make my life a little easier. We'll see what happens. Okay, so I moved the seat full forward and tilted it a little bit. Let's see if this just pops right off. I don't see how there could be any screws in here. There we go. All right, so don't be too afraid, I guess, to pop these off. Okay, this might want to just peel it away a little bit. All right, came off. And once again, I left a clip in the door, so I'll have to pull that out and put it back into the piece here for reinstallation later. But as you can see, now we've got a full run from the front, at least to the back seat. Let's keep going and see if we can refrain from breaking anything. Okay, so standard procedure in the rear. Go ahead and pull your floor mats. This one obviously just kind of folds up and tucks out the way. and then we'll start taking off some of this trim work here in the back. So I start by pulling off the foam around the spare tire. So get your handy little popper tool. Pop these up and set this out the way. Same thing, your strut tower cover in the back just pops right out. And I believe I'm going to want to try to get the rest of this stuff out. So in the back here, there's two pins that you'll get. You're going to go in between and pop out just this part, and you're going to leave the other part in. If you try to pop out both pieces, you're going to have a hell of a time at it. So just pull those out. Yep, there they go. See what I mean? Falls right out. And then this will just pick up and come right off. Okay, this piece has a few screws here, here, in the tie down top and tie down bottom at least. So let's start with those and see if we can get this panel off. In no particular order. Try to pop this out. There goes a clip. Okay, there may be something back here too. Aha! There's one more bolt that I missed behind this in your front tie down. So just pry that off. Pry this away. You'll see that bolt. So we'll pull that off and see if we can't get this the rest of the way off. I believe that's a 10. So after you pull this bolt out, you're pretty much good to go. But there's a couple of tricky spots here that I did not realize. In the doorway here, you've got these clips that basically hook up underneath the weather stripping. And if you try to pull it straight out, these clips, there's two of them, will pop off and you'll lose them. So what I did is basically just peeled back the weather stripping here and pushed this down and out. And so after I did that, I think we're good to go. So get all these pieces out, move the seat belt. I do gotta kind of finagle it around the seat, but as you can see, we're loose, and now I believe it's just the wires that we need to disconnect back here. So yeah, just gotta take off this connector. Pardon the camera shot. There we go. And that's it. She's out. Now you have full access to run the wires up through here. It looks like there's plenty of room. And what I'll be doing, not exactly sure where I'll place it yet, maybe here, is peeling back this foam and cutting a hole for that 12-volt receptacle. So yeah, now that we've got this all out the way, we can start wiring. So I'm running wires right now, and I like to keep things as close to OE as possible, which means hiding the wires away as much as I can. And I was really struggling to get the wires underneath this loom. And what I found out is that if basically you just pull up the weather stripping here, it goes right back on. It's no big deal. If you've ever installed these things by yourself, you know that the weather stripping comes off and on pretty easy. Anyway, once you do that, there's a couple of these clips here, and basically you just push in and the whole thing will come up enough for you to tuck the wires under. And then putting it back together is just a matter of clicking it right back down and then putting the weather stripping right back in. So that made that job a lot easier. So I've got my wire that I'll wire into the fuse block in a little bit. It's run up underneath this loom. And what I've done is I've followed it back here along the windshield washer line underneath the seatbelt mechanism for the driver's side. This part, I thought in the rear seat, you could do the same thing and pull up the weather stripping, but it's captured right here underneath some sheet metal, which made it a bit of a pain in the ass. So I just manually ran this through, used a piece of mechanics wire and fished that through. So after that, I've gone back and I just zip tied it to this existing loom. I did not want to zip tie it to the windshield washer line because in case you crimp it or crush it, you're not going to have fluid going to the back. This, I'm guessing, is just the, I don't know, some kind of release mechanism. It feels like a cable. But I just zip tied it to the wire bundle, the existing wire bundle, as it went back. Okay. And basically, I'm going to leave myself plenty of wire here for the power to that 12-volt block. And for the ground, I'll probably either use an existing screw or just a sheet metal screw tapped into this somewhere. We'll see. Okay, so no good projects with goes without its snags. So I got my part in from Amazon, and this sucker's pretty deep. I was originally hoping to put it somewhere around this area here, or maybe up here, the equivalent of down here or up here on the driver's side. But there's really no good spots that I can find that will accommodate something that deep. Once you put this thing in, it's going to start hitting the walls. The light switch is right here, so it's in the way. Putting it down here is too close to this part of the frame. So it looks like since the ideal spot is right here, but on this side, that's where the light switch, rather the trunk light is, and I don't want to lose that. I think what I'm going to do is move it over to this side. So I'm not going to pull all this stuff apart. I'm just going to go ahead and I popped this screw and that screw there and pulled this away so that I can access the back. But you can see if I put it here, then it looks like there's ample room right back there to make it fit, I hope. Because my biggest concern is holding this plate up as a template, cutting this spot out, going to put it in only to find out that it doesn't fit. And then I just have a hole to deal with. So yeah, I'm gonna extend my wires that I ran. I'm gonna go along the trunk plate here and up into here. You can see I've already started to move my ground. My ground, I just took up residence back here. It's a 10 mil ground that I just went ahead and tapped into. So that's good to go. My power, I'm just going to go ahead and extend. And yeah, we'll see how that goes. So right now I'm just going to go ahead and redo my wiring. Well, not redo, but extend my wiring and get that in place. And then I'll come back with the plate up there and the cutting. And we'll see if that works. So yeah, fingers crossed. Okay, so we're scribed up and I'm guessing I'm just going to go ahead and cut this out. All right. This sure would be a lot easier if it were off the vehicle, but whatever. I'll probably get criticized for my first tool of choice here, the X-Acto knife. But I can always step it up a bit if I need to. The thought is that this will give me a little bit more control in a precarious position. Let's see what happens here. Because I think if I just go over it a few times, I should be able to go all the way through the nice clean line and then clean it up maybe with a file or a Dremel and sandpaper. You know, this isn't the first time I'm actually trying to do a YouTube video with this much of a walkthrough. I wonder how many people are actually doing this shit for the first time and recording themselves having no idea what they're really doing. Like, I don't see many bloopers. Maybe that'll be my thing. If I screw up enough times, I ain't gonna be a how-to. I'll be a gag reel. Okay, rough cut. Good. See where we go. You can see it's not too shabby. Got a little bit of roughness around the edges to clean up. But I'd rather have too much material than too little. And it looks like there's plenty of room back there. Oh, that sucked. Plenty of room back there for those receptacles. This might work after all. Okay, here's the dry fit. Don't have it screwed in yet. Believe it or not, right now it's actually just being held in place by those receptacle nuts on the threads. So I will put in the screws in the four corners, but it's definitely deep enough. It fits great. It's not wired up yet. Still have to do the wiring on the back side. But yeah, I really like that. That came out nice. So stepping back a little bit, we'll have 12 volt DC cigarette lighter charger like thing there, as well as two USB 5 volt 2.1 amp outputs. So if I'm hanging out back here, can do, you know, charge my phones. If you have a travel refrigerator cooler, then you can go ahead and plug it back here. Switchable hot. Awesome. Very happy. All right, time to get wiring up. All right, so I'm going to choose this open slot here to tap. And I checked already with my voltmeter. It's got constant hot, it's not dependent on the ignition. And so that's gonna be this one right there. I had already tapped into this one here for eyesight to run a constant hot up to GoPro power. So I'm gonna go ahead. Notice I'm leaving the fuse out right now, and the reason I'm doing that is I just want to double check that after I plug this in, I do not have power to the back. That'll just let me know that the fuse is in the right spot. Okay, so it's plugged in. I shouldn't have power at the back. Assuming that works, then I'm just going to go ahead and toss in a 10 amp fuse into that circuit, and we'll be good. I'm going to test now. I should have no power.
and I have no power. Certainly not at the other side of the switch. Okay, let's go put a fuse in and we'll test it again. Okay, I've got a fuse in. 10 amp fuse. Let's test. There we go, 12 volt. And we got 12 volt, which means my switch is on. Turn that off. Check again. Switch is working. Turn it on. 12 volt. Nice. So let's see how that looks. We should be able to see. There we go. 12.5 volts. And it's off. Nice. So I'll check the sockets now to make sure that my wiring is good to go there. I'll grab a USB. The lights are on. They're illuminated. Nice. Oops. Come on. Okay, so we'll check that out. We'll check that out. I really like that the USB ports are illuminated. That's cool. I didn't realize that. All right. The screws are in. She's all set. And now we just step back, admire our work, and start to put back together all the body panels. So, good times.
Thank you for watching. If you liked this video, this tutorial, or just this mod, let me know in the comments below. Hit like. I'm relatively new to YouTube content creation, just inspired by all of those out there that have helped me in the past, and I'm trying to give back to the community a little bit. So, if you like what you saw, again, let me know and I'll do my best to create some more. Thank you again for watching and have a good one.